Thank you.
Thanks. Yeah, so thanks, Maddie, also for organizing API Days, because that's also a bit where my journey started in 2015. I was already deep diving into APIs a bit, but then the banking event of API Days in London really opened the eyes of a few within the bank, and that's where the journey of ABN AMRO started. And people, a small group of people started to feel responsible. Of course, PSD2 regulation, we need to comply to, kick-started the thoughts as well. And that combination, I'm proud of to present the results today. And now we can look beyond that and look up to the next years, what's to come. So, to explain a bit, who knows PSD2? So that's not everybody, so I'll explain a bit, but from this year and on, all banks in Europe need to share your data to third parties, regulated third parties, when you want to. So they need to have a license from a national bank, and with that license they can get access to your transaction data if you give consent to those companies. So that can be Google, that can be another bank, that can be a certain fintech, it can be Facebook. It took a long time to get to that regulation, but now it's there. What the news also shows that customers still need to become acquainted to that this possibility is there. And do we think it's risky or do we think it's useful? It's up to the customer to create their thoughts about that. But he needs to be educated also about what are the possible risks or why are those companies asking the, your data. But in return, what are the customer experience that you can get and a customer can make its own decision. And also, you see that the Dutch National Bank is educating Dutch customers at least in that sense. So there was a television campaign, there's a website put it up where customers, consumers can find information about PSD2 banking. For us as a bank, this regulation and it meant that it kickstarted an API program. And you might all be familiar with the digital channels of a bank. So of course, banks started with offices where you branches where you can bring your money and interact with people. Then we started to digitize those processes into internet. Then, and we had internet first thinking, now it's mobile first thinking. But if you look at the really big companies like an Amazon or a Google or an Apple, it's all about APIs, and APIs first thinking is really the mindset over there. So who knows, after the first two digital channels in place, API first thinking will also be the future of a bank, at least. We now see that we have three digital channels and a new digital channel coming up. And in order to understand that concept, it takes a lot of work in your company to explain what an API is. Not only to developers, because when I started in this field and I asked to developers what is an API, then they knew what the word API, but they didn't know it was application programming interface in that time. But going to business people and I said APIs, they didn't know the whole concept. And then making a slide like this, explaining like what is Uber doing, you can build everything yourself, then you need to map the whole world and you need to create your own payment system. But it's easier to reuse what others already create. And that's being done via APIs. And then you have a business proposition that you can build into an API as well, provide the cap right service in Google Maps, and that's how you create digital ecosystems. And as soon as you're starting to explain that is the concept of an API, then the mindset of business people is going to change as well. And of course, to shock them a bit, show a bit of code, and then explain, it's not as difficult as you think, because it's cab driver, his name is Bob, the location where he comes from, the location where he needs to go to, and he rides in a Bugatti Veyron with the license plate I Love Uber. And then you can also show to business people that code itself is becoming understandable and it's not that difficult to read. So these kind of slides really help to change the mindset in the beginning of your API program. For us as a bank, it means that we need to open up three APIs to be PSD2 compliant. So it's about account information, where did you spend your money on, how much information do you have on your bank account, what's your name. Payment initiation, I want to initiate a payment, and confirmation availability funds. Do I have enough money on my bank account for a certain action, yes or no? If I have this of all banks, I can create a multi-bank overview, give advice, whether you can do a loan or a mortgage, etc. If I do payment initiation, you have supermarkets that want to create new payment interactions and they have loyalty cards, and maybe you could connect those loyalty cards to your banking account. And railways could use this API to see whether someone has enough money on a bank account to take a certain train ride, yes or no. So these are the APIs that we need to launch to become compliant. Takes a lot of years, because it's in the core of the bank. Core banking systems have been built over the years. These adjustments are not light, so that's also why you see banks are struggling. But I'm proud to say that last week we launched our production version of the API, so we are there. And another slide that might help you to explain to business people, to developers as well, why this is such an important change, is just to bring some consultancy slides in. Huh? So Forrester is saying, if you don't understand digital ecosystems, if you don't understand APIs, banks, then you will become, you are at risk of starting the starting to down the slow, the painful path to becoming an unintentional pipeline, a utility. And that's something that everyone wants to averse. So they don't want to become that situation. The customer interaction is very important for a bank to help you get your mortgage or those kind of products. Then looking back to APIs itself, I started to explain which kind of APIs do we have. And also to explain that this is not really new to a bank, because we're already building APIs for quite some years. Because you have your internet banking, your CRM systems, your mobile banking, and all those systems need to interact with the same backend. So for years, we already investigated service-oriented architecture, and we used APIs to build more logical digital systems and speed up innovation. Then with PSD2, it's a combination of that technology that you already have in place, and of course you need to make adjustments, and you need to have new capabilities in place, like API management layer and security, and API token solutions, comply to the regulation as well. But if you have this technology in place for open APIs, for your compliant APIs, for your mandatory APIs, then you can also start thinking about how can I use the same technology to speed up innovation by partnering up with third parties, and which kind of APIs do they then need to build new customer interactions. We have big companies that bank with us and they already using accountancy software. Can APIs then be a solution for them to build new interactions, automate stuff, and can you get into that mindset? And each morning we are sending emails to certain offices with these are the currency conversions or the interest rates. by creating an API for those services, a public API, a lot of automation can be done, and a lot of cost can be saved. And of course, if you do it in a really good way, you can think about a freemium business model or offering the APIs for free, developer pays, developer gets paid, or all kind of indirect business models. Another slide that helped me to explain that this is not such a scary world is to show that we are already doing this in the physical world. So in the physical world, we have our ATMs in shops to be there where the customer is at. And we have branches in shops to provide provide advice, for instance, to young couples becoming parents. Because those are the moments in life that you possibly are thinking about a new bank account or mortgage as well. So think of an API and an open API to do just the same, but then in the digital world and at shops, digital shops of third parties. Then the scary part, we are not that good about of this yet. So a lot of big tech, fintech, they are already there. They have developer programs, they have a big portfolio of APIs, and banks need to catch up. But it's not only banks that need to catch up. All industries are in the same struggle. They are looking at these big techs, industry by industry, attracting new customer interactions to their ecosystem, while you as an industry would like to have the same. So take in mind what they are doing. They are coming your way. Another interaction, which is definitely going to change how people are interact with your company, is these kind of channels, the voice channels. So if I'm ordering a pizza and I want to pay for it, if I'm going to my laptop, then I get advice about the first 20 pizzas and I look at the whole menu, which pizzas I can order. If I would do it like Google, can I get a pizza? Then I'm going to listen to 1, 2, 3 pizza options and I'm picking one of those three, but I'm never going to listen to all 20. So imagine when you are going to sell your insurance or your mobile account or whatever via these kind of channels, it's triggering a different customer interaction and it's all about APIs and how do you develop them. So for us, we need to move from a traditional player with complex IT to leveraging our own IT systems, growing together with third parties into a digital ecosystem player where we consume the APIs of partners, fintech, peers, and challengers. We build the full stack ourselves, and where we provide similar kind of APIs, and we behave as the fintech, where others can build on top of us, like big tech partners, clients, etc. And that mindset that is well shown at these big techs. So if you look, for instance, at Tencent, where WeChat is making nice quotes, they are saying, we're building a forest, not a palace. So it's not about aggregating all data and keeping the customer in your own company. No, it's building a forest where everybody can contribute to the customer interactions, build nice customer experiences, and you are a provider of that environment, or you are a participant in that environment. And in this place, APIs are very important. And then it's all about moving away from being an ego, the ego system, to ecosystem thinking, where you want to work with third parties and build new stuff together. So for us to participate, we invest in multiple fields. We have invested in an API platform, and that API platform is enabling business lines ourselves to open up APIs to partners to become compliant and to sell API products. Then business lines need to think about new innovations. What can we build? How can we partner? We want to contribute and create new customer interactions ourselves as well, based on the data of other banks that we can aggregate. And you see that a big change within the company is that the developer is more and more a key player in this. So it's not anymore about demand and delivery. No, the developer is the new king in both the customer side but and within your own company. And you need to build developer communities to let those interact with each other to be successful. So that's why you need to treat them as your customer. So just like you would do with branches and mobile banking and internet banking, we created a developer portal which is showing that we are trustworthy and that we are serious about this. So if you would like, go to developer.abnamro.com and there you can see that we have our PSD2 compliance APIs in place. We have a few others. So if I click on API products, I can see all the products. And if I go to the blog, we're also quite open on which technology do we use, which events are we organizing, and what is our story in this whole picture. So again, if I'm clicking on the API products, you see the PSD2 compliance APIs. Tiki, I'll tell you in a bit. FX trade and also experiments where we are going to interact with customers in which kind of products can we build together and where is your demand. So I told you that we are going to use the APIs of other banks as well. This Monday we launched multi-banking on both internet banking and mobile banking, and now customers of both of Rabobank can also use the ABN AMRO app to view their accounts so that they can get a multi-bank overview, and we will add the accounts of other banks as well once they are ready with their compliance projects. Then Tiki, for those of you that are not in the Netherlands, it's an easy peer-to-peer payment request app. So if I'm having dinner with a lot of friends, I can send a payment request via WhatsApp. It's open, so if I click on this link, I'm being sent to a web channel and I pay via a payment scheme Ideal, and then there's a nice Giphy at the end, which makes the interaction very enjoyable. And you see that this is helpful for customers, because this is always a pain in the ass to get money back from your friends. But you also see that it can speed up the interactions, payment interactions for companies. So you see flight companies and universities and supermarkets using this same solution of Tiki as well to build this stuff. And they could do it all manually, but then it's not that speedy. Via an API, there's no person in place that needs to send those payment interactions, but it's automatically done, which is generating new value. And the Tiki Fast Checkout API is a quite new API as well, which is reusing the same solution so that small web shops don't need to ask for your name so that you need to create an account, but you could reuse the information that you already shared to Tiki. And once I click and pay with the Tiki solution, the product is being sent automatically to your house. And the last one that I'm very proud of is, for years I've been explaining this to business lines, but the FX Trade API, you really see that a business line took the whole thought process themselves, and they developed the FX Trade API. And there's a video that I would like to share.
We live in a digital world. New technologies are raising customer expectations on banking services. In foreign exchange trading, electronic platforms and apps replaced voice trading. The next level of treasury automation requires integration with APIs. ABN AMRO offers a RESTful foreign exchange API. With this API, you can receive rates, trade on quotes, and request transaction history. The API is designed to handle large volumes of small FX transactions. This allows for full protection against FX risk while minimizing manual handling. Together with the payment APIs from ABN AMRO, complete treasury workflows can be automated. Getting access is easy. Just follow the instructions on ABN AMRO's developer portal.
Okay. So like I told, it's quite a journey from the first API days in 2015 to where we are at now. But I think that we are quite successful in our journey, and we are looking forward to take the next steps with you. So if there are any questions, let me know.
Thank you.
What a journey.
Yeah,
5 years. Is there any question? There, yeah.
You just opened a development portal.
Yeah.
What are your first experience? And also, how do you go about, let me say, business cases, rewards for developers, because it's still their IP?
Yeah.
And if you want to roll out, let me say, a very good application, there's a lot of money involved. How do you go about it? Are you still in the initial phase? Do you say, well, we have to see what catches the attention of the market? How are you going to test this?
So if I'm going back to our overview of APIs, you can see that there are various business reasons why you want these APIs. So if I'm looking at account information and payment initiation, it's all it's basically compliance at this point. So we need to open up these APIs. And once the third party has his PSD2 license in place, then he can get access to those APIs. For corporates, our own customers, we can reuse those services and then they don't need to have that PSD2 license, which also costs money because you need to comply to all kind of other financial regulations. But if it's your own bank account, it can be some sort of business solution. So the connection between your bank account and the accountancy software, it's already something that bank charges for, and that can be a business model on its own. Tiki payment requests. Each successful Tiki payment request that has been done, we receive some money for. That's why we would like to do it. And for them, it's speeding up the payment process, because normally with invoices, it takes about a month for people to pay it. With Tiki, it's being shown that it's been done within one day, and even half a day for about 80% of the time. So it solves big issues for these companies. And FX Trade, it's also about FX Trade for us. If they know what the rates are and how they can use it, then they are using our platform to do it. So it's really about which APIs are you opening up for these kind of strategies. Yeah. Does that?
It's also about the monetization, because developers are now, they can get your information.
Yeah.
They can build nice customer solutions, perhaps targeted to ABN AMRO customers.
Yeah.
And I know even working with big techs, we're working with the big techs,
mm-hmm.
then in terms of monetization, how to go about it, market introduction,
yeah.
that opens up, let me say, following level of...
Exactly. So I'm also explaining that we are in the beginning of the journey. So we started with compliancy and these kind of API products, but we're now looking into the more commercial offerings and how those kind of interactions work. So if you have ideas, then... yeah, we are really in the learning phase for the next steps in that regard.
Yeah. One more question. Yeah.
Just about the ideas, maybe you can offer this to the tax office or to water companies, electricity companies, because it's really a pain to pay these bills and enter everything manually.
Exactly, and that's also where we are looking into those use cases. So big audit firms that we already trust are definitely tax offices. Those are really the industries where we can help. And where we can improve processes. So that's definitely one of the first angles. Yeah.
Yeah. Thank you, Ken. Thank you very much.
Okay.
Yeah, thank you.